Now, there's a t-shirt that I bought at the Mindvalley Live, which I absolutely adored. I wore it so much it just finally fell apart because I loved it.
What was it called?
It was the Bend Reality t-shirt.
I love
that shirt. I used to wear it all the time, and people were like, "What is that?" I'm like, and I would explain to them, "Can you explain the concept of bending reality? Because it is such a powerful idea. And so many people, like you've said a couple times in this conversation, believe that we are kind of locked in and we have no choice in the matter."
So, you know, I'm looking at the bookshelf behind you, and I'm trying to bring in examples that that relate to the books and the statues on your bookshelf. So let me read one. I see the book Awake, about Yogananda.
Mm-hmm.
And Yogananda said this: "The human mind is a spark of the almighty consciousness of God. I could show you that whatever your powerful mind believes very intensely would ultimately come to pass." This mm-hmm. is what bend reality means. It means that whatever your powerful mind believes intensely will come to pass. And we are starting to see evidence for this. We're starting to see evidence for this in the placebo effect. Doctors like J.B. Mosley, he was written about in the New York Times. He proved that you could take men who had arthritis of the knee, you could put them under anesthesia, tell them they're going to get knee surgery to fix this arthritis, but really you don't do the surgery. While under anesthesia, you cut their knee. You don't do anything. You just make two cuts. You then sew up the cuts. You bandage it. You wake them up and you go, boom, we operated your knee. And in every case, the arthritis disappears. Why? Because these men believe that their knees were healed. So if our beliefs can influence our body, can they also influence our career? Can they influence our intelligence? Can they influence how they show up in the world? And what Yogananda actually says is they don't just influence the physical you, they influence the reality that you experience. You can create synchronicities. You can create coincidences. You can create movement towards your goals. I somewhat experienced this when I was practicing with the Silver Method, seeing myself qualifying for the US Open. So I coined the word bend reality as a fun little buzzword that we were using in our office to talk about this phenomenon when, you know, people I was close to were really visualizing their goals. They would see those goals manifest. But then in 2011, Steve Jobs passed away. And Walter Isaacson wrote a book about Steve Jobs, an amazing book,
mm-hmm.
Jobs biography. Interestingly, in that book, Isaacson used the word bend reality three times to describe Jobs, his ability to seemingly sway reality to make things happen. And I believe Jobs had this ability. I believe, in fact, all great entrepreneurs have this ability. I believe every human being has this ability. What we believe to be true becomes true. We are particles of God experiencing a reality around us that is malleable, that we can poke, we can shift things. In fact, Jobs literally said that. He said, everything in the world around you was made up by people no smarter than you, and you can shift things, you can change things. He went on to say, you can poke reality, and you can create new worlds, new things. And so that is what that phrase represents. Whether you believe in Yogananda's idea or Jobs' idea, whether you believe it is a function of the law of attraction or it is the brain's reticular activating system that moves you towards goals, it doesn't matter how it works. The thing is, it works. What we believe to be true about the world becomes our world.
And a side note with that, the only book on Steve Jobs' iPhone was Autobiography of a Yogi by Yogananda.
Exactly. Oh, wow. I forgot that fact. Isn't it funny how that connected? Yeah. So in the biography, Walter Isaacson mentions that he asked Steve Jobs, what books do you have on your iPad? And it was only one book, Autobiography of a Yogi. Jobs would go to his retreat in Hawaii, a hotel in Hawaii he loved, every year and read and reread that book. And that book is literally about bending reality. It is about the world as Maya or an illusion. Maya is the Sanskrit word for illusion.
Isn't it interesting though that as we're talking, it kind of reminds me of the Matrix in a way, where Neo you know, for everybody who's not seen The Matrix, I'm sorry, spoiler alerts, but the Neo, the main character, eventually learns that not only is there is a false reality and a real reality, but he's able to, during the course of that movie, learn how to bend reality to his will. And not only in one of the realities, but in both realities. So many people would consider that the Matrix itself would be what we are living today, and the real world would be the spiritual world that we all come from. But he's able to do it in both. And, you know, everything you're saying makes absolute sense to me. And we're here, everything that's around us, we've created. Even though things happen to us, look, if a car accident happens to us, it happens to us. How you deal with it is relative. But generally speaking, when those kind of things happen to us, there's something in our lives that, I mean, anytime I had a car accident or something really bad, there was something going off in my life. But this show specifically, I'll use this example of this show, is I've been able to bring people like yourself on the show by will, by mental, but, you know, and I've had the pleasure of speaking to some amazing gurus and spiritual leaders and best-selling authors. And it's remarkable the kind of people that I'm starting to attract to the show. And that is my doing. I'm bringing them in because there's hundreds, if not thousands, of other shows like mine, but yet not all of them have the kind of guests and the kind of conversations that we have on this show.
To watch the full video, click on the link below. And don't forget to subscribe.